gentle, please.
Progress is measured in small movements.
And then push your arm forward like this.
For Elaine Young and her four-year-old son.
There we go.
Orville.
Ooh. Kind of eliminates gravity so that he doesn't have to hold his arm up because he can't.
In February, Orville underwent nerve transfer surgery in hopes of regaining feeling in an arm that literally became paralyzed overnight last summer.
So that morning weakness just stood out to us. And that was something that was consistent across all of our patients.
Dr. Heidi Moline says Orville had one of 10 confirmed cases of acute flaccid myelitis, or AFM, in Minnesota last year. The polio-like illness also surged across the country in a very specific way in the last few years.
And it shows that every 2 years or so, there's a spike in the fall, and they mirror the spikes that we see in enterovirus. D68.
Moline says doctors have long suspected that the fairly common enterovirus D68 is linked to AFM, but it has never showed up in testing until the analysis she led at the University of Minnesota.
It could be a huge link to helping us understand, you know, more about this process and where we go from here.
Elaine knows it's too late for her son. She just hopes it's a sign of progress.
Getting more funding for research and finding out why it's happening to certain kids and not others, and finding a treatment that might be able to stop the paralysis would be extremely helpful.
Dr. Moline says that morning limb weakness they found in all of the cases they studied could also be a key to helping doctors test children for the virus and identify AFM earlier in the process, ideally before symptoms worsen.
But Ken, as far as they know right now, there's nothing they can do to reverse the effects?
Nothing they can, besides some surgeries like you saw there involving nerves. And that's something that does not and will not bring back full feeling to before this set in.
All right. Thank you, Kent.